So, Philip, you messed up. You messed up real big. And you had a really great opportunity to put out an actual apology to Boomstick Gaming. And the one thing you don't do is you don't apologize to the person that you clearly plagiarized. In the terms of practically every professional wrestling fan, why don't you boys go ahead and take it away?
You fucked up! 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 You fucked up!
So, Filip Miucin puts out an apology video where he apologizes to IGN, he apologizes to practically everyone else except to Boomstick Gaming. In fact, he even goes on the point to say that Boomstick Gaming is, I'm paraphrasing here, basically trying to gain some sort of clout from Filip and from IGN to keep doing what he's doing. And he was a YouTuber at one time and he knows what it's like, and just to keep at it and he'll hopefully gain some success. Well, you know what, Filip? You were doing this while you were monetizing your apology. You were putting yourself out there. You didn't actually do anything to apologize to the person that you plagiarized, and you went through and decided to say, hey, you know what? You can do it one day too, buddy. It'll be okay. That's honestly not the way to do things, and it's not really what people were expecting you to do. It's quite simple. You clearly made a mistake, and the mistake you made was going through and looking at other reviews before you wrote your own on Dead Cells. We don't know whether you actually played the game. We don't know whether you actually went through and wrote your own review. We don't know anything about it, the fact that you were the editorial lead on this review. You are the sole person to make sure that what you're putting on is your protected work, and it is work that you made yourself. Now, other people are going through a lot of your other reviews and saying, well, you plagiarized this, you plagiarized that, and I think that's a little bit more tough than what really needed to be happening. See, the thing is, a lot of reviews go along the same thing, and people are really pointing out other issues where other reviewers would actually say the same thing about everything else. I mean, these are things that are mostly read through this spec sheet or whatever product placement that they'll be getting whenever they get a review, really basic things that they're saying. The problem is that Filip went through and fully quoted full-on sentences and structures and phrases and barely changed anything about what he was talking about from Boomstick Gaming. That's the big issue. And the fact that he still did not apologize, and now the video's actually been removed and taken down, it's even more shady and more showing of what you've actually done and what you're refusing to just say. All he had to say, all Filip ever had to say was, I'm sorry. I made a mistake. It was a bad judgment call and I shouldn't have done it. That's it. That's it. There would be no issue. There would be no concern. He would have blown it all out of the water and it would have been water under the bridge. And if you just would have said something like, Boomstick Gaming made an excellent review, please go check him out. The guy has a very bright future, and I apologize for doing what I did, and I sincerely hope you can forgive me and continue to, you know, give me a chance. Simple. I mean, everybody would have been like, you know what, dude? Yeah, okay, fine. You know, you fucked up, right? You messed up. You did a thing that you weren't supposed to do, and you messed up, and you owned up to it, and you moved on. That's all you can do. But then Filip does the one thing that I really didn't expect him to do, that I've seen people say happens quite often in the gaming industry, and he's playing the victim. He's playing the full-on victim, claiming victimhood, that he's being attacked by Jason Schreier, going through his journalistic duty to see if he actually did plagiarize other pieces of work and reviews. He's blaming the victim on people sending him death threats, although that is not fucking cool. No one should be doing that. And you definitely shouldn't be doing that to his family either as well. But that has nothing to do with what you did. People are uncool all the time, okay? I get death threats. Doesn't bother. Whatever. Block. Simple. Right? His family's getting death threats. Very uncool. Very, very uncool. But turning around and playing the victim, that you are the one that's being harassed, you are the one that's having the issues, you made the mistake, Filip. You needed to own up to that mistake quickly and make sure that what you did doesn't happen again. And I guarantee none of that would be happening to you right now. The problem is that you decided to go through and you decided to cover yourself up and try to do what you can to mitigate the damage instead of just owning up to it and being honest with yourself. You plagiarized something. Deal with it. You know what you shouldn't have done, and you did it. You know that you should be reviewing games on your own and formulating your own opinions and then putting out your review as an editorial lead for the article and then having that as your own body of work. But no, you went back in your video and you stated that you reviewed other reviews to gain a formulative opinion. Nobody does that. It's their review. It's their thing. Now more questions are arising. Did you actually play the game? Were you not able to have enough time to make the review? Was the embargo too short? Was the game something that you didn't enjoy? We don't know. And now, you've practically ruined it for any other YouTuber that wants to go through and actually try to gain a job in the games industry. Because now they're going to say, is this YouTuber going to go and plagiarize something else? We don't know. Now we can't take that risk. Filip, you did something incredibly idiotic. And instead of owning up to your own stupid mistake, you turned it around and you tried to say that Boomstick Gaming was practically trying to get clout from you and from IGN. You tried to play the victim by signifying that you've been threatened. Although that's not cool, that still doesn't mean you need to play the victim. And then you apologize to IGN and you apologize to Dead Cells, but you don't apologize to the person whose work you stole. The guy doesn't have a job. He lost his job, and he's trying to make something out of himself on this platform, trying to do something that he loves, to go forth and actually push something and do something great with his time and really get out of what he hates to do and do what he wants to do. And you turn around and you take his body of work and you place it as your own and you expect like nothing's gonna happen. There's only one thing left to say, and I think Jim Cornette can say it best.
Thank you, fuck you, bye, boom!
Hey, so thanks for watching. I know that this video was a little bit more of a rant and I was a little bit angrier than I normally am in a lot of other my videos, but I wanted to give you guys a quick update about what's going on. I am actually changing my Patreon. I've decided to do something to help people get better. And what I've done is I've structured my Patreon in the sense of personal training. I decided to put some really affordable pricing for personal training. If you want a customized workout plan, meal plan, nutrition plan, anything you need, any questions, I have plans that range from $15 a month to $45 a month. The $45 a month tier is every week we talk things out, we break things down. The $25 a month tier provides you with twice a week workout regimens and updates. The $15 tier is once a month, and we just go over your personalized routine, personalized nutrition, what you're eating, what's missing, what's going on, and then we move forward from there. So I decided to try and provide you more of a service rather than just trying to take money. So I figured out that would be really cool, but if you still want to donate just a dollar or anything else like that, that's totally fine as well. I really appreciate it. In the meantime, though, I do stream on Twitch every so often. I stream on YouTube as well, so please check me out there and check out the Press Start podcast. So I'll see you then and have a good one.